That's how it depends how you interpret life, you know. So I've always been living with these dreams in me, believing that one day they'll give birth to reality. Right now, when I look back where I come from, I feel truly blessed because at some point I felt I was nobody. At some point it was not easy for me to go in the trash bin and look for food so that I can eat and my brother can eat also, you know. And I would ask myself questions and questions and questions. Still today I don't have answers. But I realized that the only way for me to be a better person is to stop asking questions, is to stop blaming, but start taking initiatives, do something, and then you'll make a change, you'll make a difference. So today, here am I. I don't ask questions anymore. So I don't want the poor child to ask the same questions I ask, because it's difficult. Nobody's giving you answers, you know? One of Bob Marley's songs, Natural Mystic, where he says, there's a natural mystic blowing through the air, and I won't tell no lie, you know? Many more will have to suffer, many more will have to die. Don't ask me why. Things are not the way they used to be. And it's true, when I look at this with my spiritual eyes, I can see, where are those people who used to greet each other in the street? Where are the little girls who used to grow up believing that one day we want to become somebody, today seeing themselves being nobody? What happened? You know, where is the spirit of Ubuntu, where Africans would really get together and embrace each other despite of material and other things? I don't know what happened. So these are questions, you know, you ask yourself questions, but who will give you answers? Your duty, your work, you making a difference, you know, that's exactly what can give you answers and fulfillment inside. So that's life, that's the way it is. Believe in yourself, believe in who you are, and don't just believe and sit there and smoke and start fantasizing, you know, being in your little world. It's not all about that, you know. When you smoke, your whatever you smoke, you know, smoke, but you know, you should know choices that we make today determines the future. That's why today, when drugs are introduced in our communities, people just jump into drugs, they smoke, you know. Today what happened? Destruction, no values anymore, no community anymore, high rate of early teenage pregnancy. But we as Rastas, you know, we smoke our herb, and I fear no one by smoking my herb. And it's not as something that I can be proud of, because it's something that is so spiritual to me, and it heals me. They've said this and this, you know, you're going to die. People are too judgmental. They don't look at what you can produce or what you cough out from your mouth. They look at what you eat, and that's a problem, because you judge me with what I eat. You judge me with my hairstyle, you know. You don't judge the works that I do, because men shall be judged according to the works that they do. Faith that has no action is dead. So I have action in my faith to show that I believe in this. I understand what I'm doing. And that's why I prosper through the powers of my Most High. So it's about believing in yourself, you, before it can be about them and us. It starts with you first. Kids that I work with me, whether it's kids, elders or adults, I always try to kind of help people to let their little light shine, not my light shine. Not let them to let whatever light shine, their light shine. Allow them to be who they are without making them uncomfortable. Yes, along the way you might see as if they are losing direction, they are going to be the worst people. You're not God. Just allow them. When you were a child, you had childish thoughts, you had childish plays, and then you grew up, you become matured now. You no longer do childish things. Nothing wrong when kids are doing childish things. So my kids, I always make them feel that who you are is best than any other thing in the world. Mahatma Gandhi, the greatest inspiration, once said, be the best you want to be in the world, not the best that the world wants you to be. And I agree with Mahatma Gandhi. Mother Teresa, one of the great women who did powerful work, said, if the world is actually depriving you an opportunity, or the world is criticizing you, saying, You can't do it. Do it anyway. If you want to start the program and the world say, no, forget, you can't. Mother Teresa says, do it. You know, if the world say you can't feed those children, feed them anyway. If the world say, no, it's too much, not for you, for them it's too much. So be the best that you can be.